Welcome to the home of the Chiefs. I'm bringing dance moves.
I'm bringing the swag.
I'm bringing my Jandals.
And this was on the show today. Charlie.
My middle name.
Yeah.
Is actually Sigrid.
You come from a smoking background, your family?
No.
Yeah, I guess so my other passion is ink. Unfortunately, it's not my wife's passion, so I have to get the brownie points right up here to get new ink.
Bro, did you used to bring it on back in high school?
Nah, bro, I was too cool for that, bro. I used to do street dancing.
Show me then.
You sure?
Oh,
yeah.
The
beatbox. Grab my feet.
Yeah. Oh.
Ready, dogs?
Yeah. Oh, wow.
Delicious.
No. That was a big slap. That slap, bro. Yes. Of a queen, I turn up. All the pretty bitches love me. I need mouth full of gold with them berry curls. Dutton and some pretty shit, diamonds and pearls. What's up, everyone? We are
Christy.
Hi, we're Dutch and Sid from the Royal Family.
We are the Lost Boys.
We are Ho. What's up, everyone? We're Paddy Crew.
Hey, what's up? We're
Debbie. Who are we?
Ma.
Where do we come from?
ID code.
Yo, what's up? We are
the Brothers.
And we're here in Auckland at the SDNZ Nationals 2015.
It's amazing. I mean, I remember my first comp, I think 2007, and it was a lot smaller than this and not as popular, but now it's grown into this and the standard has gotten so good.
Yeah, I've definitely noticed how it changed. I've been around for a long time. I've been here from when it first started. The level of street dance or dance in general has gone to a whole new level where New Zealand is actually, in my opinion, is actually at the top.
Our signature dance style is crump because we just really feel the mana and like the energy.
The most important things that we have brought to the stage is performance.
Raw energy.
Oh, we were feeling Missy Elliott, so we went all the way old school with these fresh Adidas tracksuits. Is it worth it? Let me work it.
It's been really, really good and a lot of competition, but it just motivates us more to go even more hard.
That vibe when you're backstage is pretty mean.
We put so much of our energy and love and time into this, just for like 2 minutes on stage, it's crazy. But what I enjoy is I enjoy seeing the kids grow, seeing them become confident in themselves, which is probably one of the most valuable things you can learn as a person on this planet, is to believe in yourself and to appreciate what you have, which is your talent and your heart, what you love.
We would like to just give props to the Royal Family as well, and for the creativity that Periscope comes up with and the dedication of all the dancers. And it's amazing, you know, for them to win a World Championship 3 times in a row is incredible.
We're signing out. Peace.
Yeah.
You know you're fresh when you're
running through the streets with my love.
Keep it fresh, powers up.
Here are some fresh Chiefs facts. Augustine Pulu. He thinks he's a gangster, but he can't speak English properly.
Ben Tamiofuna. Fresh fact about him is his hygiene is very fresh.
Real fresh.
No, not even. Something fresh about Tim is when he
decides to go to lunch, he makes all of us pay for it.
Oh, bro, that's right, eh? What about Liam? When he comes in the middle of the day and does abs, but still has no abs. That's pretty fresh, eh?
Anyways, here's some real fresh chips. Fish chips.
Fish packs. Fish
packs. You go with that, buddy.
Here's some real fresh chips.
And welcome to a French Bag, your favorite part of the show that helps you improve your thinking. Think about that and think about this to make an intelligence. This week's subject is the ancient Bulemalay Mound in Savai. Yeah. See, this is a very mysterious thing. The Bulemalay Mound is like a pyramid in Samoa. Amazing. Now, this thing is not a proper pyramid. It's got a flat top and it's made up of heaps of stone. Ooh. It's also known as the TSCO Ancient Mound, the largest ancient structure in Polynesia. It's situated in Palauli, at the east end of Savai'i. Letolo is a plantation in Palauli. Now, this structure is said to be bigger than Heiau in Hawaii. Now, it stands approximately 65 meters by 60 meters in a square and stand up about 12 meters tall. And historians say that this thing was probably constructed about 1180. Yeah. Some people thinking, where is it come from? We're not an Egyptian. Yeah, well, there is this one theory. It's come from this Chauka from Norwich. In 1947, Four Hayatel tried to prove it that we come from the South America, and he sailed on a raft all the way to the Pacific Island. But it's never been proven correct. Time and time again, it's never been proven that this theory is true. But I think he's thinking about how come our headdress look like the one on Apocalypto. Pyramids in Samoa, think about it. Amazing. My name is Mutua Potuteri. I hope there's an interest to you. And I look forward to giving you a more interest from my encyclopedia brain.
Ominous.
Stay tuned for more freshness. But if the America's Cup wants some more grinders, my mate over here's got you.
Get him, Locks! Get him! Turn the corner, turn the break! Oh. Turn the corner, turn the break!
Here's all of my family. Ooh, I got 8 in my family, 4 boys, 4 girls. 5 of us are adopted.
High five!
High five!
Oh, mate, do you watch the new Fresh TV? That's that girl.
Yeah.
She is beautiful, man.
She is smart.
She is kind.
Yeah.
She can do anything, man.
She can be my girlfriend?
No, she can't.
Welcome back to Fresh.
This is what we get up to at the Chiefs.
And there's something from the Messam Sevens, my world.
My nickname is Hunger. To cut a long story short, I'm always hungry and always eating. The freshies on the team started calling me Hunger since they couldn't really pronounce hungry properly, so that's why it's Hunger. Kia ora, I'm Liam Meesam, and welcome to my world. I guess playing for the All Blacks is the ultimate. You know, that's what you want to be when you grow up. Every little kid, that's why he eats Weet-Bix, to be an All Black. So, it's just a dream come true. It's hard to describe. You know, I love being in that environment and I work hard every day to stay there, so.
Meesam again! Liam Meesam!
And it's Liam Meesam. Oh, he did really well.
He gets it away to Liam Meesam! Can he get there?
Get up!
Mate.
How are you?
Good to see you.
You're good?
Yeah, good game.
Thanks, boy. We're down here in Hotapu in Cambridge, where I'm running a Meesam Indigenous Sevens. This is a tournament just to unite all our cultures. New Zealand's a multicultural country, and I just thought it was a great opportunity to get all the cultures together, have a good day. And, you know, rugby's our number one sport here, so that unites us. I I brought the sevens here to Hautapu because this is my club and this is where I first started playing rugby when I first moved up to the Waikato. So just a good opportunity for myself to give back to the club, which gave me a lot in what I've done.
I reckon it's really good, especially with someone like Liam Meesam, who's played sevens before and that's where his career started off. And I think for him to start this up is pretty much giving back to his community.
And I've got my young team here, Team Messam, that's going over to Hawaii. I remember when I was just a young fella going to tournaments like these and really having that passion afterwards to have rugby as a career, and that really drove me. Faith's the first and foremost important thing in my life. There's three things I live by, and it's my faith.
Oh, sorry. Sorry about that.
Faith, family, idiot, and my rugby. That's my auntie, Fleur. Look at her big bum. Fleur, show your big bum. Turn around. Yeah.
Let's
keep it real. Boys, want some TV time?
Yeah.
Smile to the camera. Here's all of my family. Ooh, I got eight in my family, four boys, four girls. Five of us are adopted. Then I got a whānau family, and there's about a million in there. So it's good having best of both worlds. I got Samoan links, Māori links, Scottish links. William Wallace was my uncle. Yeah, so bit of a fruit cocktail. My whānau is my rock, my wife and my young fella. When I say my young fella, my life sort of changed everything that I thought about life definitely changed. So yeah, a lot of happiness, and now I play a bit more rugby with a bit more enjoyment now. So he's around here somewhere running around, probably stealing some lollies or doing something. Smile for the camera, boys. Bula, bula.
Bula, bula.
And the same thing applies. You're on the front and I've got your inside.
Yeah, so the Chiefs boys are trying to try their hand at coaching. They're lucky enough to have some good manager, Ben yeah. Samia Funa. Paulie, what are you?
Masseuse.
Oh, the Chiefs are pretty fresh. We just enjoy what we do. It's the culture, it's who we are. Yeah, I guess my other passion is ink. Unfortunately, it's not my wife's passion, so I have to get the brownie points right up here to get new ink. Like I said before, I'm a bit of a mixed cocktail or fruit salad, so I've got Samoan tattoos. My wife's, she's Cook Islander, so I've got some Cook Island tattoos in there. Tahiti, Māori. I've got my new one, to the wee little Taniwha. So yeah, just everything that I've been through life, I've been there, and also got my wrist done. It says Thug Life after Tupac. Nah, it says my family, my life. So it's, you know, it's my rock, as I said, so.
Coming up after the break, more fresh from the cheese freshness.
Keeping it fresh.
Keeping it fresh.
Perfect fit.
Yeah, it's my size.
It's pretty small though, eh?
Nah.
Oh, I mean, it's pretty big. It's pretty big.
July.
July.
Miguel, come here, Mira.
Yeah, babe?
Whose lipstick is this?
Oh. Oh, wait, hold on. Oh, no, it's not my shit. This my mate's shit.
Miguel, don't you lie to me, papi.
Hey, babe, I'm not lying to you.
Don't you lie to me.
I'm not lying to you. I promise. Oh, this Tony's shit. Tony, this your shirt. Come get your shirt, Tony.
You're so
welcome to Fresh. Sometimes when I need a helping hand or advice, I always go to my man Liam, the hunger buster. Bro, how do you get a big chest like that?
So it's like this. Gonna make them dance to the music. Doo, doo,
doo. Struggle with that.
Struggle.
But here's the man with all the advice, Pastor Sam, with Confessionals.
Sam.
Welcome, Matcha. What would you like to confess this morning?
Anything?
Anything.
When I was like 15, I was on my way to church, worship practice, and I really needed to go to the toilet.
Yes.
So I just didn't make it to the toilet in time.
Okay.
So I went to toilet in my pants. I just bought them. They were brand new Rip Curl blue pants. And then a couple of weeks later, my friend was really mean to me and I knew she always wanted these pants. So I cleaned them up.
Yeah.
And gave them to her as a gift.
Oh, okay.
And she still doesn't know today.
She still doesn't know about this. What you do in the pants, and then you you give the pants to her. Yeah. Okay.
And she loved them. She wore them all the time.
So I have a pants in Iriga for this will help to cover this sin that you did it. And because you do the out of revenge, what we're going to do now is give me something out of luck. Lunch on one day, washing on the other, and then you can pay my phone bill. So you do it for love. When did it happen to you?
15.
15, and you are now?
16.
16, so 7 years. You, 7 years you're going to have to do this thing to help to get rid of all this. Any other sin that you want to confess so we can make sure that you have a clear mind and when you go on stage, you can perform with a clear soul and spirit?
My middle name
is
actually Sigrid.
You come from a smoking background, your family?
No.
It's a cigarette?
No. Sounds like it. Sigrid.
Sigrid.
No, Sigrid.
Of silent H.
Sigrid.
Rid. Richard.
What?
Rinsett?
Sig.
Oh. Sig.
Rid.
Rid.
Sigrid.
Sigrid.
No, yep.
Yeah.
Yep, you got
that's it.
That's
one. Sigrid.
Yep.
That's a nice name.
I don't think so.
You know where that name actually came from?
No.
I don't have an idea. Maybe that's the secret. Thank you for coming. You're taking up a lot of my time now.
Okay.
So how do you feel about talking about this thing?
I feel light.
Yeah. I wish I felt light.
You know when you're fresh, when you're working really, really hard.
Anyways, here's how fresh are you.
How fresh are you? Oh, the street's eating me. I'm here with my friend, Mr. Swack. The man himself?
Yeah, the whole package.
Mm. Oh, okay. Mm. Can you tell me what this is called?
A jandal?
Yeah, do you know what it's called in Cook Island?
A jandal? A jandal?
Can you tell me what this item is called? This one.
You see a vibe.
What this is?
That's a jandal.
My shirifa. Oh,
don't feel it
right now.
Slippy.
Oh,
slippy.
Is it because sometimes you get a slippy on the face?
My face.
What do you use it for?
Well, my mom used to use it to give me a hiding when I was small. Snake up.
But violence is not the answer, eh?
Yeah. No, violence is not the answer.
Violence is not the answer.
Swim?
Oh, yeah. Pedal?
Pedal.
Patu? Yep.
Boots?
Yep.
Boomerang?
It's more they have very big feet, so they...
Yeah. You know what they say about big feet?
What? Oh, that's perfect fit.
Yeah, it's my size.
That's your size? Pretty small though, eh?
Nah.
Oh, I mean, it's pretty big. It's pretty big. Oh, your slipper's pretty fresh, eh?
Yeah, slipper's very fresh.
Simba!
Yeah, that's how we do it, Simba! You can use it to play music.
Oh yeah, show us a sample. Go, drum.
Someone give me a beat.
No, you just drum. 10 out of 10.
Oh, thank you.
Boom.
Gentle. Yeah.
So gentle. So gentle.
So gentle.
10 out of 10, man. High five.
High five, yeah! Simba! 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 Sale!
That's it for today's show. Thanks for coming along. And here's what's coming up next week's show.
Surely.
Welcome to Freshie vs. the Wild. My name is Gus Mutialo. I've been sent here on a mission to survive the next half an hour to present Fresh. But first, we must look for food.
You know you're fresh
when you have a man bun like Ben Tamefuna.
The
disgusting.
Keep it fresh.
Fight, I think I like the amor got long and late by the